ladies and gentlemen, Merry Christmas from a different country. I'm no longer in Serbia. I'm actually in this nation here today. This is the flag of Bosnia-Herzegovina, which is one part of this country. You've got the Federation of Bosnia and Republika Srpska, where the Serbs live, and we're in the Federation today. The biggest city in Bosnia, Sarajevo is the name of it. And Sarajevo is a city I've always wanted to come to since I've been in Serbia. I researched lots of things about Serbia, of course, and in reading about Serbia before I moved to Serbia, I found out a lot about Bosnia and a lot about Sarajevo. I am a big lover of shisha, or hookah, or nargila here in Serbia, which is flavored tobacco that the Arabs tend to smoke. And there's lots of them here. That's one of my main things I want to see. Sarajevo is also known for lots of really good čevapi, pljeskavica, and rostil, which is like meats. All the barbecued type meats here are really, really good. Grilled meat. Sorry, I always say barbecue. It's grilled meat is what it is. Anyway, Sarajevo is a city of about maybe 500,000 people, half a million people roughly here. You've got New Town and Old Town. Last night coming in on the bus to come here from Belgrade, I took a little tour bus. It's like $15 each way, 15 euros from Belgrade to here. Takes 5.5 hours. Once you get into, you leave city Serbia by Loznica and then you get over here, man, the roads, this country is so hilly. Sarajevo is close to the center kind of it. And you go through every road is up hills like this. But it's really pretty, but it was dark out. You couldn't see a whole lot, but the towns were lit up, Christmas stuff. But anyway, the flag, a little bit about the flag before I take you around and show you this beautiful city, is to tell you a little bit about the flag. I've never really liked the Bosnian flag. I didn't think it was that, you know, aesthetically pleasing to me. But they say on this flag, just so you know, blue, white, and yellow, they represent peace. These, there's 7 stars and 2 half stars. These are supposedly Europe, I think is what they say. It's Europe for the countries in Europe, and they just didn't have enough room on here. That's why there's half stars on here. And then they say this square, this triangle piece resembles, has similarities to the shape of Bosnia-Herzegovina, and the 3 edges represent the Serbs, the Bosniaks, and the Croats. Because there's 3 nationalities here. And when you look at Bosnia, the shape of Bosnia, it is similar to that. It looks kind of like this, but down here is Herzegovina in the southern part. There's a lot of Croatians live there because the border's down by the southern part of Croatia. And then the Republika Srpska part goes in the outlining areas around it, kind of like a backwards 7, or no, like a 7 from my look, from the way you're looking at backwards 7. And in the middle part is the Federation. And Herzegovina is that southern portion, and the rest of it's Bosnia, okay? It's kind of a strange makeup of a place. But anyway, I found a place on Airbnb right here in the heart of the city, $30 a day. You can see I've got this kind of Arab-styled couch that they don't have edges on it, and it's got lots of pillows. And it was nice. The guy had to meet me. We didn't get in here into Bosnia until I got here like 12:45 last night. So this young man, he's a Bosnian gentleman. Of course he is, that met me here. He had to stay up and wait on me to come here. I got it on Airbnb. Really nice little place. I mean, it's nice enough for me. And I'm right next to the police station. The Bosnian police station's right here in Sarajevo. So I'm getting ready to go out. I'm going to go explore. I'm going to see where Gavriil Princip, the Serbian, shot Archduke Ferdinand and his wife here, which they say is the cause of World War I. That's very debatable, of course, but he did shoot him. He shot him, and depending on who you are, if you're a Serbian, you look at Princip as a freedom fighter who was trying to get rid of this archduke in this monarchy who came here to force their beliefs onto these people. If you look at it from the other side, the Serbs were aggressive and killed somebody, okay? So depending on who you are and what you believe, that's who you're going to like Princip or you're not going to like Princip. But anyway, we're going to see the spot where it happened. I'm going to take you there, and I'm going to take you a couple other awesome places. There's a lot of history here in this town, and a lot of it I wanted to see based on the Bosnian War, because I watched a lot of movies and documentaries about the Bosnian War. So there's some things I want to see. Hope you enjoy it. I'll show you some food. I'll show you how to make some Bosnian coffee. They've got some special coffee here and the way they do it, and we're going to have some fun, guys. It's Christmas, and I'm in Bosnia. Don't be genius.